Meaning, I need you to find me 70 people that you can trust.
Yes, sir.
I need you to find me 70 people that you can trust, that you believe that this thing that you're barking upon, they gonna take it like it's their own.
Right, that's right.
You need to find you some folk that'll come around you that's not trying to hold you back.
That's right. But trying to push you forward.
You need to find you some folk that don't sleep less you sleep.
That's right.
You need to find you some folk that dream the same dream as you. You need to find some folk that know how to elevate you instead of holding you back.
Come on.
I need you to find 70 real friends. 70 real brothers. 70 real sisters. 70 people that got your success over their mind.
Three.
God had Moses to take 70 elders. What God said I'm going to do is I'm going to take your spirit and I'm going to put it on the 70.
Yes, that's right. Preach.
This helps with the weight of the mountain.
That's right.
You can't carry it all by yourself.
That's right.
Come on.
But when you got like-minded people,
that's right.
Folk that's on the same page,
that's right. Preach.
Folk that got the same goal.
That's right.
Folk that like what you like.
Right.
Talk like you talk.
Yeah.
Move like you move.
Yeah.
I guarantee you, you get stuff done.
Yeah.
Just a little bit quicker. Problem is, it's hard to move your mountain when you got so many people around you that can't wait to see you struggle.
Say it again.
Can't move your mountain when you got people around you that holds your mountain in place so they can see you fall off.
Come on.
You got people working against you that smile in your face, but they're helping you to fall down to the ground. And you need people to work with you. God told Moses, choose 70 out of Israel. What I'm going to do is I'm going to give your spirit to them. You got to watch the folk that you're around.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
In order to move your mountain, you're going to have to surround yourself with people that want to see you where you see you.
That's right.
Let me say that again.
That's right.
Surround yourself with people that want to see you where you see you.
Yes.
Stop hanging around folk that can't stand when you get a little bit past them.
Y'all ain't talking back to me.
Stop being around folk that can't congratulate you when you get a new suit. Can't be happy for you when you got a new car. Don't know how to praise God for the stuff that you praise Him for. Separate yourself from people. I believe God will put people around you that will lock into the same vision. Task that God has planned for you to conquer. The next point is that it's not hard. It doesn't take much to move the mountain. But the truth is, don't y'all get mad at me.
Talk.
Y'all don't get mad at me.
Enjoy it.
You don't get mad at me, y'all.
Enjoy it.
But the truth is that you got too much. Truth is, you got too much going for you. I'm just telling you, it really don't take much to move a mountain. Sometimes you go into the battle stacked. You got too much on your side. And God can't work a miracle when His glory is in jeopardy. See, some of you asking God to do something. for you, but his glory is in jeopardy. So he ain't gonna move.
My.
Don't get so big that God can't show you his power.
Say it again.
I said, don't get so big that God can't show you his power.
That's right.
The text to support this is comes out of the book of Judges. 7th chapter, we'll read it real fast. 2 through 7. Says, and the Lord said unto Gideon, people that are with you are too many for me to give the Midianites into their hands, lest Israel vaunt themselves against me, saying, mine own hand hath saved me. Now therefore, to go to proclaim in the ears of the people, saying, whosoever is fearful and afraid, let him return and depart early from Mount Gilead. And there returned the people, 22,000, that means 10,000 people left out of fear.
Come on.
32,000 And the first break, if you're scared, go home. 10,000 people leave immediately. What that is an indication of this. That 33% of the people that you are around are afraid of the battles that you've got to face. I said 33% of your friends. That means if you got three friends,
one out of three,
one of them is afraid. If you got 100 friends, 30 people out of the 100 is already afraid. That's why everybody ain't geared to go where you going.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
Let me keep reading. And the Lord said unto Gideon, the people are yet too many. Still got too much. Yeah. After I done cut you, you still got too much.
Yeah,
you
got too much. Yeah.
Bring them down to the water, and I will try them there for thee. It shall be that of whom I say unto thee, this shall go with thee, the same shall go with thee, and of whosoever I say unto thee, this shall go with thee, the same shall not go with thee. So he brought down the people to the water. And the Lord said unto Gideon, everyone that lappeth the wall of the water with his tongue as a dog, him shall thy set by himself. Likewise, everyone that boweth down to the knees to drink, the number of them that lack to put their hand to their mouth were 300 men. All of the rest of the people bowed down upon their knees to drink. And the Lord said unto Gideon, by the 300 men that left, I will save you. And deliver the Midianites into your hand. And let all the people go, every man to his place. First of all, Gideon was 32,000 strong. And Gideon was ready to go to battle. And sometimes when we got ourselves halfway together, looking good, got a little money in our pocket, Gideon was together. He had 32,000 folk. He wasn't scared of nobody. Because he had himself together. We will get ourselves together, get a little income tax check, and we just feel like we got everything going on. Baby, we getting Michael Kors. We going, huh? You wait till you see me next Sunday. I'm going to show y'all something. We got ourselves together. Don't mind even paying an extra money rent. So we don't have to worry about the one just for a little security. But notice God told Gideon that you got too much. You got too many.
Yes, sir.
And if I let you win with this amount, you will say it was by your own
hand
that you were saved.
Yes, sir.
Some of you don't even pray and ask God what to eat anymore.
Woo!
Hallelujah. Because you are so independent and your refrigerator is already full, you ain't even got to pray about what to eat.
All right, man.
But when you didn't have no money,
talk to
it.
Talk, sir.
Ah.
Come on.
We won't have in that refrigerator.
Come out.
You will break yourself. You will tell the Lord, I don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
But God, I put it in your hand.
Yes,
and God is saying, I'm missing my relationship.
Yeah. That's right.
All
right. God says, you got so much. You're focused on the gift and not the gift.
Yes,
we done got to the place where we focus on what God give us
yes.
and not what God is.
Yes, yes, yes.
Then God sees his glory fading away. Because you already got enough gas to put in your car.
Lord, have mercy.
He can't show you he can make a way out of no way to come.
Yes.
Amen.
You done made the way already.
Come on.
Your job done made a way so you ain't got the way of God no more. Y'all, I know you don't like this here. God can't get no more glory on your job. Because you got it together, man. And God says, that's when I start an elimination process.
Yeah.
You think you got it together, God starts slicing yeah. stuff out of your life.
Yeah.
Y'all don't know what I'm talking about. Some of you ain't even know.
Yeah.
Then once you find out God done took half of your income tax money, you trying to figure out what happened. You done messed up because God done start slicing.
Yeah.
He start cutting the people like he start cutting your life just like he cut the people over here.
Yeah.
I'm going to save 10,000 of
them.
Half the income tax gone. You can't sow seeds like you want to. You can't pay your bills like you need to. Because when you pay your bills, the rest of your money gone. God said, I'm trying to get you back so you'll start trusting me. You got too much right now. And as long as you got all you got, you won't lie on me. God has become to remove anything and anybody that tries to steal his glory. So Gideon got rid of 10,000 people and left them with 2,200. And God said, this is still too many. Some of you lost so much, yet you still don't know how to give God glory. You pouting about what you lost instead of focusing on what is the gain.
Yeah.
God said, when you find a way to praise me with the little you have, when you can't praise me with the little you have, I gotta find a way to cut the munch.
My.
God said, I don't need a mega ministry of 5,000
members. Come on now.
Just give me 50. That lap like a dog.
Come on.
Yes.
God began to prune the people again to 32,000 became 300. Less than 1% of what he had. We think we got to have all these things to show that we are blessed. But God is saying, don't mistake your own handiwork with my blessings.
Lord have mercy.
Lord.